Hi, I'm Scuba. This is the Fact TV Singles Club. We're going to be listening to some tunes today, and I'm going to be saying if they're crap or not. I don't really know what the point of that is. Like, it's got this kind of like, it seems like it's a real kind of like sort of late 90s electro type vibe. And then it has this sort of almost sort of grime influenced sort of bass line and these sort of computer game effects. And I'm just listening to it and I'm struggling to work out what the point of it is. It's sort of intentionally bad, but then I don't really feel like I can slate it because it feels quite well realised. I mean, it is basically shit, but I mean, but I'm wondering how shit. I mean, it can't be above a 5, surely. But then I feel like, you know, I feel when I say it is shit, I just sort of feel like maybe I'm missing something. Maybe I'm missing the point of it. Let's give it a 5. I think that's pretty generous, to be honest, but yeah. 5.
I can say hello, my only one, just like the morning sun. You keep on rising till the sky knows your name.
I think that Kanye West is probably the single most overrated entity in the world today, with the possible exception of Paul McCartney. So, generally speaking, this collaboration for me is, even without listening, I mean, I'm not coming at it from the, you know, the most unbiased perspective, most fair perspective. However, you know, I'm always willing to give things a go. And that was fucking awful, frankly. I don't know what they're thinking. I do know what they're thinking. I'm thinking that, I'm pretty sure Kanye's thinking, yeah, I'm amazing and anything I do is great, but everything he does is shit. So he's wrong and he should fuck off and probably die horribly. And so should Paul. They should die together. They should like jump off a building and die. Because that, you know, Paul McCartney, right? You know, the Beatles are, you know, think what, you know, say what you want about them. For me, like, you know, they're, you know, you can't deny their cultural significance, but a lot of the music is shit. But equally, a lot of the music was great and seminal and groundbreaking and, you know, modulations in pop music, you know, well done, great. But basically everything since then has been really, really shit. And I mean, I think that's been kind even. So for him to turn up on this with Kanye is, I mean, it's not a big surprise to me, put it that way. Yeah, okay, 1. That was shit. I'm very into broken techno, generally speaking. The sort of heavily distorted aesthetic that's going on here, I think is quite cool. It's quite well realized. I mean, the thing about this kind of stuff is that, like, on paper it's quite easy to do, but actually, like, pulling it off in a convincing way is harder than it might first appear. I remember hearing his really early stuff, and it was, you know, really obviously made by someone who didn't really know what they were doing, but still had that quite cool sort of aesthetic, quite cool attitude towards it. And I think we're making techno, like, attitude is really a large part of the, well, actually the main part of the whole thing. And like I said, it's well realised, and I think it's cool. So we're gonna give it a, we're gonna give it a 7, I think. Because it's a good track. Okay, so, I mean, I've been a big fan of Zed Bias for, you know, many years, like lots of people. You know, the stuff that he sort of came back with, the sort of Song 81 stuff, I thought was quite cool because it was a definite sort of step away from, you know, what he'd initially become, you know, known for. And this sort of seems to me like, you know, it sounds obviously much more like that kind of stuff, but it's just a little bit sort of middle of the road. I don't know, it's kind of like, I mean, with the vocal, it's sort of almost like, what's the point of having this vocal in there? Because it doesn't really add anything to the track for me. I mean, you know, it was nice Skippy DeBias drums and, you know, but it's just like I say, it's just a sort of like, it couldn't really be more average, to be honest. There's no standout element of it, you know. There's kind of this sort of bass line, which, you know, they probably knocked up in, you know, 30 seconds. And then on this, there's this drop, and then like it comes in again, and it's just the same bass line. And it feels like these guys could do it a little better. But having said all that, you know, it's a decent enough track, I suppose. So we will give it a 6, I think. Sorry, guys. Oh,